What's up, y'all?
Oh, what's going on? Whoops, starting early. So what is this, the eve of Christmas Eve?
Yes, if that's such a thing, but it is a thing because we're in the now.
Right.
Happy Christmas Eve of the Christmas Eve.
There you go.
Yes.
That'll work, yeah.
Yeah, so Mary.
What's going on?
Hello, this
button around the house. No, not really. Just getting stuff ready for, because tomorrow's a big day. I got a lot of cleaning I need to do. Because as you see now, you can't even sit, walk, do anything in that living room. So yeah, it was clean, perfect for Thanksgiving, but now it's almost like an Amazon stock room in there. But as part of, it's a family thing with us. It's like that.
Right.
Like a lot of, but it pays off because everybody has, my dad has a good time. With both sides of the family, mom has a good time with both sides of the family, they're on. So, that's all that matters. And they're older. Yeah. And I have fun, you know?
Oh, yeah. Isn't your brother coming here?
My brother Mike.
I've never met him, Mike.
Steve, I haven't, my twin brother Mike is coming. And Ronnie, his roommate.
You believe this guy has a twin?
Yes, there's two of us. So I'm looking forward to that. He'll be leaving sometime in the morning from Myrtle Beach,
right,
South Carolina, and headed here to Mooresville.
Right.
Yeah, which means if even if they left at 9,
yeah,
or he says he left at 9, might be here anywhere between 5 or 6. There'll be family starting to gather for the Christmas. This happened about 3 or 4 years ago. He called and said he's coming, and then he said they were leaving the next morning. We were leaving to go over. Actually, we were going to my Aunt Cheryl's house for that one that year. It's crowded, but we went over there.
Now it's been a couple of years since I've spent Christmas at the Rosses.
Yeah, place. Yeah.
So
you can be there. I mean, obviously you're coming Christmas Eve tomorrow.
Yes.
But you know, Christmas night, dad's side of the family's coming.
Oh, yeah.
I know you got to go to Huntersville. What is that right now?
That's just a long.
Yeah, but we're not doing that until 5 or 6, so.
Yeah. They got a room, you know, at the
okay, yeah.
The
sure, sure. Man, that's great. That's great.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Memories, man, yeah. You need to take some pictures, Steve.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, make sure you charge it up. And if you don't have a charger, I got one in a fitted. I'll check it out tonight if you want. Maybe you can charge it overnight.
I'll just buy some batteries.
Well, yeah, buy batteries.
Right.
Well, no, those batteries are kind of rather, well, you've had it a while.
Who cares? I was enough batteries.
Yeah.
Yeah, Mr.
Man, yeah, take some pictures, absolutely.
I hear you.
That's good. We got the lights fixed. They went out again. True to my word.
Oh, yeah.
I might as well be in a buffet if we go to the Bocce Grill. I might as well say, give me some of the red.
Yeah.
Some of the green. You know, because Uncle Eddie's going to be out there fixing the Christmas lights. They burn out again.
Yeah.
Thank you, whoever is the guy who distributes most all of the name brand, the house brand version of the Walmart.
Right.
Icicle lights.
Yeah.
Not even the house brand, the other ones.
And
also.
Why are they that little, yeah, little tiny fuses?
You have the, yes, yes.
Little tiny,
you have a micro
glass.
Mini fuse.
Yeah, the old
glass. That if I leave on more than 2 days, here's why I know that the quality has digressed.
Yeah.
Because I've been doing it consistently now at the Ross Estates for over 2 decades.
Right.
Hang on, ever since the early 90s, I got to where I was like, hanging lights. So I know how that they, the quality. It used to be I could get them down.
Yeah.
I could actually unplug them instead of stepping off my step stool. I just drop them down on the ground.
Yeah.
No bulbs right now. You better lay it down ginger.
Oh,
and if you let the cord with the metal end that's a little heavy here, you've shattered a couple, Or God forbid, And just to check a fuse to see if it's blown, to open it up, you're going to blow the fuse.
No doubt.
It's like surgery. It's like playing operation. You saw what I have. Needle nose, extreme needle nose.
Yeah.
I thank God for the tiny micro mini straight screwdriver because I can just reach in there and pull them up.
Right.
I'm almost like, all right, blow needle nose. Sutures. It used to be I could, and even when the lights started to go out back then, this sounds so ghetto, but it got to where I could just shake them one good time, hell, they come back on, put them back up, and they would be long, they were good.
Yeah.
Those were known to where if one or two in a certain part of the sections, they got to where they split them in two sections,
right.
So two fuses, that only those part of the lights would go out. So instead of you searching all 1,000 lights, you're looking through Yeah, you know, it's from this section to this section. There's something amiss.
Right.
You know. And by God, those wouldn't blow out till basically you not only just broke the glass and the little fuse inside.
Right.
But like, you know, you had to basically destroy a bulb. It would burn without no glass or plastic on top.
Right.
Now, man, and they make it so hard to replace them. Like, you have to have a little meat screwdriver to pry it up, then pull it out. You know.
Yeah.
It's like, for love of Pete, man.
Well,
they're putting too much quality in the keychain and bowls when it don't even last long.
Right.
Yeah. In fact, how I was testing fuses of snares out of old ones was when I would guess at which one on which side, not guess, but I could figure out right's using the far end, left's closer.
Right, yeah.
If they were out, I would change those fuses and that, and I was putting them in those new sections of lights that Chris bought. I've got lights upstairs. I got enough lights, Steve, to light up all of the roof lines of the house.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. If we had the plugs, by God, they'd be plugged in.
It'd be like McCaffinville.
Man,
know?
I would use two different remotes, do like this, and I'd have them blowing up, baby. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Just like the Griswold on the...
Exactly like that.
Yeah.
I don't mean to be, but that's just what I...
Well, like I said... Now, my parents had this H-Rap.
My dad has this album.
We used to go camping in that ground. Oh, yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, yeah. What? Yes. I love this song, too, man.
Right.
By the way, guys.
Well, my parents, yeah.
Soundtrack to Graduate.
Yeah.
You guys, that's another genre you need to look up. That's a great movie.
Oh, yeah. Well, I heard the soundtrack and then I saw the movie.
Yeah.
I thought, well, gee whiz, I wish I would have used more of the music in the movie.
Yes.
Well, just like Zorba the Greek, you know, that's an excellent soundtrack. And right. An excellent movie. Anthony Quinn, yeah. We're now looking forward to the holidays at the Ross Estates.
Yes. I predict the police will only be over there that week twice.
Oh, well, yes. Unless there's an accident. Oh, no.
Yeah. Maybe just one cutting. I don't think there'll be any shootings this year.
Sure
somebody might get, you know, a little cut, a little jab.
Maybe
but you'll have that. You know, burnt bread. Somebody's
stabbed.
Oh, no. You know, somebody might leave the biscuits in there, you know, the bread cooked too long, and then Uncle Larry might get stabbed again.
Right. Oh, wow. The pork.
Yeah. No, he goes to go get a pack of Marlboros an hour and a half. He comes back bloody and stabbed up. He's got some girl named Cinnamon. He swears he's his girlfriend, but she's 20.
Right.
You know, like she just comes straight off the hooker track.
Of course.
Yeah. And he reeks of alcohol. And he's in a different car than he left.
Yeah, I know. Oh, boy.
Well, Merry Christmas. Come on in. There's one song, the Christmas song they used to play on Jumbo and Billy. They still do it.
Right.
Where he's like, it's the one, I can't remember his name, but he's like, when Sandra had to run down to get a bag of smokes.
Right, okay. Country art.
Yeah. We're like, you know, but it was a parody.
Yeah.
It was great, man.
Well, no, because the Cheech and Chong one was so cool.
Right,
and,
right.
You know, even the projects, you know, they weren't anymore, you know, the old man.
Right.
Oh, man. That guy sounds pretty heavy, man.
Oh, sounds pretty heavy, man.
Oh, yeah.
See, now, I thought this was Simon. I thought you got Simon and Garfunkel's greatest hits.
Right.
You have that.
Yes, I do.
Well, why aren't we playing that one?
Because this is more instrumental. This is more mellow, you know. It's Christmas or the... Eve of Christmas.
Well, you can be all the better to have the lyric, the greatest hits.
Wow.
I would say.
Yeah, being Julio, yeah. Well,
yes. I like it.
Right. Well, you mean Julio,
I mean, I feel like I ought to be shopping at Sears back in the day when they had Muzak pumping in. You know, or JCPenney's.
That's why I love this record.
It's like being at Ingles in the 80s when Grandma was buying me a dozen donuts from the bakery, freshly baked.
It's like elevator music.
Right, exactly. But, you know, by the way, Muzak, the company, went bankrupt.
Right.
Why and how, nobody really knows.
Right, yeah.
They just, a horrible whatever investments.
Right.
Yeah. They are. Right. Of course, they marketed all of your Baccarat playing. Up in the elevators, you know? Ladies and gentlemen, we just like to tell them that we need the Eagles. The bakery has its fresh made rotisserie chicken, so we also have.
Yeah.
face to face. Yeah.
Wait, here comes the blue light at Kmart.
Or yeah, you're at Kmart, like we like to show. Attention Kmart shoppers, we'd like to tell you.
Oh yeah.
It will be a blue light special coming up in 5 minutes.
Oh yeah.
5 minutes.
Well, I know, but
you never seen an old country woman named Bertha Moose.
Before the blue light special, we're gonna take a break.
Right.
So tell Mavis we'll be right back.
All right, we'll be right back, Mavis.